One of the main things I love about the ash forest is actually the smell. It's such a wonderful thing to be able to come into these forests and stand under these enormous trees and just close your eyes and smell and listen to the bush. Because of the extensive fires over recent years, there's actually a substantial area of forest that's at risk.
There's about 22,000 hectares of immature ash affected by the 2020 Victorian fires. This project aims to treat between 8 and 10,000 hectares of immature fire-affected ash in Victoria. We're aiming to ensure that we don't convert ash forest type to non-forest type. The project is funded by the Native Vegetation Improvement Stream as part of the Reducing Bushfire Risk program. With the help of Melbourne University, Parks Victoria and Greening Australia, we devised a process of prioritising which areas we're going to target for fire recovery.
The Alpine Ash Fire Risk Mitigation Project was a project designed to explore the potential risks of losing alpine ash forest in the future, in particular to changing fire regimes and changing climate. We run simulations and explore the potential for alpine ash to persist or not persist.
The initial project, which was funded by Safer Together, was set up a couple of years ago. My role in this project was understanding how we can utilise the information from that mitigating fire risk project and use it in a way to help prioritise where we need to reseed alpine ash forests after the 2019-20 bushfires.
We intend to sow around 4,000 kilograms of seed in this fire recovery effort for alpine ash and up to about 2,000 kilograms of seed for mountain ash.
If you think of the Great Dividing Range in Victoria, it's huge. My role is to provide a scientific and technical recommendation on where to sow, how much to sow, and how to achieve a regrowth forest. We can forecast where in that massive landscape it's going to flower, and of course flowering leads to seed. Once we locate a site, we call the climbers in, and the climber will climb the tree, he will delimb to a prescription. About 50% of the crown is taken. Individual branches. The nice thing about that is we can keep the tree alive. We're looking for large, you know, well-formed capsules. And then we have a team of ground collectors that come along and collect all that capsule material into a bale for later processing.
Behind us is a seed extraction facility, which we use to get the seed out of the capsules. We mimic the natural process of a fire under the canopy, heat up those capsules, the seed falls out. We grab that seed, clean the seed, and we store it in a refrigerated container for future use in fire recovery. So we're working in partnership with Vic Forest to provide seed collection and management services, as well as aerial sowing using helicopters.
Local knowledge and knowing how good the seed bed is really critical for the seed to be sown and germinate on. We've got to match ours in the air to the shapes on the ground that we want to sow. We know where the seed was collected from, so geographically where it sits in the landscape. And so we try and get the seed that's closest to that site that's been burnt. The helicopter has a seeder. There's a hopper inside the helicopter where the seed can be loaded into. So the helicopter pilot flies the seed over the shapes that we've nominated.
This program this year is, I would say, the largest program of its type ever implemented in Victoria, certainly single event in Victoria and most probably Australia as well. So we went into this fire season with a lot of forest at an age where it was, I guess, reproductively immature and quite vulnerable to this event. And it's a really vast area, so we had about 70,000 hectares of ash forest impacted. But we're not just talking about this value or that value, we're talking about what that forest provides as a whole in terms of, you know, all sorts of values, including biodiversity and catchment values, even cultural and economic values as well. Most people would agree that ash forests are some of the most beautiful on earth. It's really important we try and, you know, restore these forests as best we can.